Well, we're a little more than halfway through 2022, and animation has been interesting. And because I'm lazy, I mean, it's summer, you guys, so I'ma make this quick. So this weekend, I sat down and watched Paws of Fury. Okay, technically on Friday, because the rest of the weekend, I was on vacay. Just look at your boy. Oh yeah, the movie. So in my trailer reaction vid, I talked about how it has been almost 8 years since the movie was originally supposed to be released in 2016. It has been stuck in development until its recent release this year, and you can't help but wonder, was following through with this film really worth it? We'll get into that a little bit later. Anyways, the story is about a world full of cats. Can't really say I'm a cat person, you know. Anyways, it's common knowledge that dogs hate cats. Not always true, but in most cases, yes, and these cats passionately hate dogs, which becomes an obvious problem when the main character, Hank, finds himself illegally crossing the borders of Catland and inadvertently becomes a part of a large scheme created by the evilest cat of them all, Pikachu. And yes, they do make a joke about his name sounding like Pikachu. He wants to impress the Shogun, who in ancient Japanese times was basically the ruler over a land for a temporary amount of time. See, this kid paid attention in history class. The only problem is that a small town that sits right in front of the palace is of course blocking his beautiful view. So he sends Hank the dog as a samurai, so the townspeople will kill him and he can arrest all of them. It probably sounds more complicated than it actually is for what is a pretty simple, straightforward movie that interestingly scratches the surface of a prejudice allegory that kind of gets played down by its relentless jokes. It has really been a while since I've seen a movie's humor be so hit or miss. There's a joke at the beginning of the movie that's so lowbrow and bad, I nearly turned off the movie. I'm not even joking. I won't play the clip, I would never put you guys through that, but if you watch the movie, you will know what I'm talking about. The rest of the humor ranges from juvenile to very clever. For example, Pikachu has a giant jade toilet put into the palace, and there's a reoccurring joke about jiggling the handle on the toilet when it overflows. That's so hilariously relatable, I cracked up every time they made it. On the juvenile spectrum, fart jokes. There's really only one scene with it that oddly enough worked better in the trailer than it did in the actual movie. Just blatant crude humor, which I'm honestly not a fan of. Also, there's a ton of breaking the fourth wall jokes, like this one.
But what can that plan be? Why am I asking you?
Visually, it does have a very Western feel to it, along with a good dose of added Japanese flair for style and uniqueness. I actually really liked the backgrounds. They were very well done, if not pretty simple, which is probably the best way to describe the animation and characters for this movie. It's definitely not Pixar or DreamWorks, but it's definitely not bad, and the characters move pretty smoothly. I actually didn't mind Hank as the protagonist, who was likable enough, and Samuel L. Jackson as Jimbo, the surly mentor, was especially good, a role that has basically become his wheelhouse. Basically, what if Master Shifu was played by Samuel L. Jackson?
What the mother father cocker spaniel's going on here?
The soundtrack also seems pretty inspired and is very reminiscent of those 80s martial arts movies. Just listen to a little. I'm getting major Kung Fu Panda vibes. But that's basically where the similarities to Kung Fu Panda end. Everyone thought, even I, that this might be a ripoff of Kung Fu Panda. Instead, it's apparently a remake of a late 1900s adult comedy called Blazing Saddles. Yeah. How odd. How very, very odd. Also, there's this sumo cat played by Korath, who I ended up really loving. Look at him, he's like a big old teddy bear. So, can't really say it's one of the best animated movies of the year, but at least it's fun. If a dog and a cat fighting around in a giant jade toilet sounds of any interest, then you can probably already guess if this movie is for you or not. It's decent, nothing special. I can definitely see some memes coming from this. Was it worth it? Probably not totally, but I'm cool with it. Too bad the box office doesn't agree, but that's my review, 3 point something out of 5 stars.